DJ Solstice back here with another gig. Today we are back where it all began. Back where you saw the first gig log here in Morro Bay, California. Same concept, neon dance. I think it's like Mad Hatter, Alice in Wonderland themed inside there, so neon acid trip if you want to say. We've got a big package. These guys like to go big. We got the confetti, we got the CO2. We got all the goodies. We got all the fun stuff. So let's go on inside. Let's get this set up. And let's get this show on the road. Let's go. Psych, no time lapse. But here's the completed setup. We got everything all ready to go. I injured myself in the process, of course, but it's okay. A little scrapes and bruises never hurt. So let's take a step back. Capture the entire setup. So up there, making the laser projections. Those are the Laser World DS3000s. You've seen them, you love them. Nice and high. Away from everybody's eye level, so nobody gets hurt. Around the room, we have 12 of the wireless LED PARs. Uses up lights. You can turn around and go that way. And then, as you can see, it's like an Alice in Wonderland theme, so that's hence why there's all the decor. I've got a couple black lights along the back wall, and in their little tent time machine thing over there. So that looks cool too. Well, let's go to the main attraction, is the whole setup right here. So behind me, you see two truss towers. Those are global truss, 3 meter truss. So this is about 9.10 feet, let's say. Got a pair of those. Washing those and washing the crowd are 6 of my wireless LED PARs, as mentioned before. They're very versatile, use them for a lot of things. That's why I love them. And as you can see on the truss, we have the atomic LED strobes, one on each side. Key is symmetry. I'm always symmetric with my setups. To the right and left of those are the blinders. They're LED blinders, but they give off both a warm white and a cool white. So they're multifunction, and they're LED, which is great. On the floor, we have the CO2 cannons. In the middle on top of the sub, we have the cold spark machine. I had two of them, but one of them has given us some issues. I'm gonna hit up the factory and get that fixed, because that's unacceptable. But either way, we're running with one in the middle. Keep it symmetric, keep it nice and even. You got the Dragon front boards, 5-panel facade, plexiglass and wood. Looks nice, durable, sturdy. Love it. Under the speakers, mini deckers as usual. There's a CO2 cannon down there. Moving around the back, we've got the two 50-pound CO2 cycle tanks on each side, obviously. And all that lighting is being run, laser spring run off of laser. Quick show. And the lights Caleb is going to be running freestyle. He's holding the camera today. We got two more of the watch lights up there. And behind the facade, we have the 1 meter pixel bars. To control the CO2, we have a simple on off switch. This is the American DJ PC4. That way, I don't have to worry about DMXing those. When you DMX special effects, sometimes you need to keep it on a separate universe. It depends on your lighting software, and that's what mine is running into issue with. So every time I try to DMX these CO2 cannons, when I fire them, everything else kind of throws offline. So we're easy enough. This way I can control them and works out fine. Moving on to audio, everything is running through the Mackie VLZ4 mixer. Subs are being fed in aux mode, so we can control the level of the bass independently of everything else. Torque 2.0, Kyle PD8, M Audio Exponent. U-Leader headphones, also the CN4. Got my fan down there, keeping that cool. For audio, we have the QSE K10.2s, a pair of them, and a nice little array of QSE subs. We have two KW181s, two KS118s. That's the whole setup. That's the whole setup. Looks good. Looks great. They basically, what they do, these are like choir risers, and so they kind of set it, they make the room a lot smaller because this place is humongous. So they make the room a lot smaller, but they can still pack a couple hundred kids in here. So we're gonna have a good time. Remember, this is where the first gig log was, so if you want to compare things, you can compare it to that. But this one's gonna be more lit because we got way more fun stuff. So let's go. I'm ready. Caleb, you ready?
Yep.
Let's do it. Ah! So this is the aftermath. We are all done here. I guess I missed the last 20 minutes of the dance, but no biggie. You guys can see how lit it was. Hope you got a good good demo of all the lights, all the lasers and everything. Storage ran out on the camera. That's what happened. But it is time to pack all this up and get out of here. So we gonna start taking everything down and get out of here as soon as we can. But I hope you guys enjoyed it. As always, leave a big thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Smash that like button, subscribe if you're new around here. I don't know, we're tired, we're having a lot of fun. Let's get out of here. Ring the bell if you want to be super awesome. And that is it for this one. That is it for the season of dances. It's been a long one, but we've had some lit parties. I'm really sad I didn't get the last 20 minutes of this because it got really super lit, but it's fine. You saw it, and that's it. Let's get out of here. Let's go. Until next time, y'all. Have a good one. Peace.